Chapter 23rd, Part B. So we are talking capitalization process. So the next one we do is, for example, a property listed for sale has a net operating income 15,763 NOA per annum, which is assumed to be perpetual and constant. It means it remains the same, it doesn't change. The market capitalization rate is 9.5%. So basically, yield is 9.5%, right? What is the maximum price a prudent, wise investor should pay for this property? So you have to find the, the market value, right? So what's the formula? NOI divided by yield, right? So what is the NOI? 15,763 divided by 9.5 equal to 165,926. You can use your calculator even, right? So basically, so 15,763 divided by 9.5, then you have to do multiply 100, then you'll find, right? Yeah. So did you find it, right? Right? Yeah. So basically is also known as NOI divided by cap rate, right? Equal to investment. So then we're gonna do the estimate the market value for property C. So property C rounded to the nearest $100. So the result you can round it to nearest $100. So the comparable A. So what do we have here? Comparable B, comparable C. A, sale price is 190,000. Gross potential revenue 38,000. Operating expenses 25,000. Vacancy is 3,800. So what is the formula? Finding the market value for subject property. If you want to, so on the right side is a subject property, right? There's a question mark. We have to find the sale price of the subject property, right? So what is the formula? Gross revenue minus expenses. So what is the gross revenue in the first one? 38,000, right? So I had 38,000, right? So 38,000 minus operating expenses, how much? 25,000. You can write there, right? Minus vacancy is 3,800, right? So 38,000 minus 25,000 minus 3,800, whatever you find divided by sale price. So what did you find? 9,200, right? So divided by sale price is 190,000 equal to point whatever 0484 comes, right? Similarly, you do the same thing to the B, right? So what is the gross potential revenue there? 49,000, right? So 49,000 minus 32,000, which is the operating expenses, minus vacancy is 4,900. So what do you find? 12,100 divided by 220 equal to, you find 0.055. Again, you do the same thing for right? So basically, but you don't have a sale price there, right? So you can't do that until, so what do you do the next? So then you add both of them. What do? You add both of them. Both yields. 0.04842105 26 plus 0.055000, right? Equal to 0.103421. Whatever it comes, divide by 2. Find the average. So what do you find the average? 0.051. So now you're gonna use the same formula, right? Which is 12,600. Where do you find 12,600? 54,000, right? Gross potential revenue minus 3,600 minus 5,400. You find 12,600. But this one we're gonna divide by the yield. the percentage, right? So because NOI divided by yield, right, cap rate equal to, we found 243,688, and you can round 688, you can make to 700. Did you understand? So what is the formula to find the market value? Gross revenue. What's the formula? Gross revenue minus operating expenses minus vacancy rate divided by sale price. And to find, so then you can both yield, you can add it and divide by 2, right? So basically you can solve 3 of them first even, right? And instead of dividing them by sale price, you divide here by the yield, right? So once again, the formula. What is the formula for finding the gross revenue, right? What is the formula to finding the market value? Gross revenue minus expenses, operating expenses minus vacancy rate, right, divided by sale price, right, or divided by the yield, right? Average yield. So, and then we go to the next one to find the market yield. What did we find before? Right? Now we have to find the market yield. So what's the formula for market yield is? Number one, vacancy rate multiplied by gross rental income. Vacancy rate. What's vacancy rate is 4%. So higher vacancy rate. Right? And then gross rental income is how much? Right? In the first one, ABC one is 12,000, is 124,000, is 124,000. So what do you do? 4% multiply 124,000 equal to 4960, equal to, that's a bad debt. That's a bad debt. So 4% multiply 124,000 equal to, you find 4960. Then you can do the second one too. So the vacancy rate is 4% and the gross potential rent is how much? 138,000. So 4% multiply 138 is 5520. So what is the next formula? Right? So basically, then you do is a minus, what was the formula? Right? Minus expenses, right? Right? Whatever you find, minus expenses. So what were the expenses? So in ABC was 44,000, right? And the other one, XYZ, was 50,000. So you minus them. And then you divide by sale price, right?